looks actually pretty badass with the fire in the background.
This day has been so messed up. At least I can talk to Rachel now. If I can find her back here.
What's up, Steph? Chloe, it's Steph. I'm on my way to the hospital. Like you told me what happened. Poor Drew. I'm still stunned. Thank you for what you did. Shit, I'm glad you're going. Let me know if I can help more. Thanks, I will.
I've already seen what happens when Rachel plays with fire. Rachel plus swords should be fun.
Loads of fun.
After all the work Steph did, it's amazing that she would drop everything to be there for Mikey. Hey, Dana.
Did Doug dig David's garden, or did David dig Doug's? Did Doug dig David's garden, or did David dig David's garden, or did David?
I don't know. You sound kind of crazy.
See, another reason to be thankful for my recent life change.
Oh, what's going on back here?
Hey, Samantha.
Shh.
Nathan, please.
I can't do it, Dad. I'm sorry.
Keep your voice down. Now listen.
You don't understand. They all hate me. They're just gonna laugh at me.
Why do you suppose that is?
I don't know.
Because you show weakness. Just like you're doing right now.
But Dad...
When will you learn that this isn't about you and your problems? This is about the Prescott name. My name. You will not embarrass me. Nathan.
Yes.
Good. Now. Break a leg. I'll see you after the show.
Wow. He turned on a dime. I'm just gonna stay quiet for this one.
Nathan.
And you actually look pretty cool, Nathan.
Fuck!
You can see why he turned out the way he was, though. No parents would be pressuring their kid that much just for a name.
Hey, Nathan's dad is some asshole, huh?
I know. I wish he'd just go away and leave him alone.
Oh, you care so much for him.
Nathan's dad sucks. But you should be careful what you wish for when it comes to parents.
Oh, Chloe, I wasn't thinking... I'm sorry.
That's cool.
For what? You didn't kill my dad. Or did you? That was a joke.
I know. Your dark sense of humor reminds me a lot of Nathan's.
Don't.
Actually, the two of you are really similar.
God damn it.
What the hell does that mean?
I'm serious. You're both artistic and surprisingly sensitive. You've been through a lot, and a lot of people unfairly judge you for it. I think you stood up for Nathan yesterday because you know what he's going through. Nathan's hurt, and he needs help. But whenever I try to help him, it always seems to make things worse. If you were Nathan right now, what would you want me to do?
Give him space.
When I'm super angry, I need to let it all out. The last thing I want is someone trying to calm me down. Case in point, how pissed he was when we tried to help him yesterday. If I were you, I'd give him space and wait for him to come to you.
That actually makes sense. Thanks, Chloe.
Seriously, stay away from him. The dude's crazy. You don't know the type of shit that I know that he can do.
Slut shaming?
Sluts shame themselves.
Another witty rebuttal by VC.
Nice. Should I go and talk to him anyways?
Boys changing tent. Thanks, but no thanks.
Alright, never mind. So the girl's changing tent should be over here. Ah, Mr. Keaton, the drama teacher.
Mr. Keaton.
Why, if it isn't the muse of the Blackwell Drama Department. Tell me, young lady, do you still believe true love is a lie?
Definitely.
For sure. The only person you can trust in this world is yourself. Everything else is just hormones and fairy tales.
A cynic's wisdom takes no prisoners. Budding dramaturge, may your propitious appearance counteract the tragedy of Stephanie Gingrich's sudden recusal. An emergency, she says.
Excuse me?
Word.
Stephanie was our lion of the light board, but platitudinal though it may be, the show must sojourn forth.
That dude is weird.
Yeah, barely understood what he said. I guess the lights aren't working? Maybe play around with him.
Chloe Price presents Firewalk. Laser Light Spectacular!
So that no one was there to enjoy the show. Alright, let's go. I don't care about Doug. How's your super long errand going? The crazy shit happened in Drew's room. Like, really bad. Oh no, are you okay? Do you need to talk about it? Yeah, later. Don't worry until the show is over. I'm backstage. Great, on my way. You're not here yet?
I should find Rachel.
Rachel?
Oh, Victoria. What are you doing? Whoa. What the hell are you doing, Victoria?
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit.
Oh, yeah.
I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink.
I just talked to Damon. He said he had to come down hard, didn't see you. What happened? Did you find the money? Price, where's the money? This is serious, quit fucking around. Unless you're dead, apply. It's me tomorrow, have answers. Maybe I should have gave the money to Frank. He can give it to Damon directly. Cause now, I think he's gonna give it to his dad. And that's just gonna fuck everything up. Well, shit. What we got in here? What kind of pills are these?
Muscle relaxers?
Coming, Rachel?
Hurry now, before your tea gets... What are you doing here? This area is for cast and crew only.
I'm here for Rachel.
I'm here to support Rachel.
How nice.
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever.
Don't
Rachel
it.
Amber, It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night.
Oh,
as
God.
A way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
It's laxative. Wow.
That, thanks?
Let's distract Victoria.
Hold up. Did you hear that?
Hear what? I didn't hear anything.
Oh, I hear it now. It sounds like Mr. Keaton's calling for you.
He is? Oh, he probably wants my thoughts on the set dressing. Okay, don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
Oh, does she know?
What's going on? Bitch, dosed your tea. That is the least surprising thing ever. What should we do?
Switch the cups or not? Less that. Switch the cups.
Problem solved. Damn, Chloe Price. What would I do without you? Have super relaxed muscles, I guess.
Mr. Keaton's busy with Nathan. I'm sure he'll call on my aesthetic sensibility soon. In the meantime, let us drink. Oh, make sure you drink it all. Your instrument will thank you.
I'm so sure.
I am so grateful to have such a kind and caring friend as you, Victoria.
Aw, samesies.
Ugh, I hate her even more. Samesies.
Samesies too.
Anyway, I'll see you out there. Break a leg.
So, that happened?
Just when I thought this day couldn't get any batshit crazier.
Sweet Carnation, we're ruined. The show is ruined.
Now what?
That was quick.
My dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas, devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed. I'm afraid we may have to cancel.
So,
truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate.
Mr. Creighton, I have revelations to reveal.
You're drunk?
Rachel Amber is on drugs. Look at her. Her face is so blurry and pretty. She's clearly been drugged. I mean,
right.
Drugged herself. She loves drugs. Don't you?
Wow. That is some seriously good muscle.
Touché, fates. Touché.
Well, that's a shame. Not really.
What? No.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
The cynic.
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
She is indeed. Tell me, my dear, have you ever acted before?
I'm a great liar.
Hell no.
She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And she's fantastic at it.
My dear, what if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
No pressure.
I'd say you're super fucked.
Chloe, please. For me.
Why'd you have to say that?
Damn it.
Oh, she looks really good in that. And she's a crow.
I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this.
Can I play the rest of the game as this? Alright, let's look at the script.
I seriously have to memorize.
Oh, goddamn. Don't tell me I have to actually memorize it. All hail, great master. I come to answer thy best pleasure. I boarded the king's ship in every cabin, aflamed amazement, the fire and cracks of sulfurous roaring, and the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bowed waves tremble. Not a soul, the king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped, cried, "Hell is empty, and all the devils are here." Have I actually heard of this play before? Alright. Chloe, the show's starting. We got great seats, where are you? Oh, you'll see. Alright, let's do this.
By accident, most strange, bountiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to this shore. Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose. Come away, servant. Come.
Ah, shit. I'm on.
That's you.
I am ready now.
Get up there.
Approach, my Ariel. Come.
Damn it. No problem. I've got this. I just walk to Rachel and say my line.
Don't do anything. Hey, Rachel.
All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure.
Most fearless, generous spirit, hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
Oh shit, I did have to memorize it.
I boarded the king's ship. In every cabin, I flamed amazement. The fire and cracks of sulfurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble.
My brave spirit, who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason.
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried,
"Hell is empty."
Cried, "Hell is empty, and all the devils are here."
Yes!
And that's all I remember.
But are they, Ariel? Safe?
Alright. I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
Shit. To the rock. To the rock. To the crate.
How now, capricious friend? Thou art not done.
Damn it.
If thou art tired, thou must needs repose.
Yeah, I'm tired. Tired of this play bullshit. I need a breather.
Oh god, the whispering. The whispering's bad. We're just doing improv. It's fine. Look at the light. No, we go to Dana, right? No, we go to the shipwreck?
I'm definitely supposed to do something with this.
So we stand here. Okay. I stand up here then.
Not a hair perished, and as thou badest me, I have dispersed them about the isle.
In loops. In groups? In groups.
In
that sounds good.
Groups!
What's Juliet's ETA?
Ah, shit.
Ariel, thy charge exactly is performed. But there's more work.
More toil?
Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised.
How now? What is't thou canst demand?
Liberty?
My liberty.
Indeed.
Okay, got that one right.
Thy liberty?
Maybe.
Nay. This, most of all, I will not grant. That's not her line. Is it?
Oh.
What's going on?
Now we're really improving.
But thou assured my freedom. Didn't thou?
I never said how dearly I hold thee. My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend. Is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress. Most truly, it is so.
Oh.
Mr. Keat, they're way off script. It's magical.
Then why, I pray you, wish you to be free?
Oh, this is deep. This is actually hitting really close to home right now. Excitement will grow old.
Excitement ages quickly. And I fear if we set out in search of new, fun, you'll tire of me. And, then I'll be alone.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
So come with me.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend, for but a little longer I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes. And when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty is forgot. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Are we getting married?
Say yes!
Yes, I am most pleased. Your duty done for now, so go forth hence with haste. I've work to do.
Thanks, Chloe.
Well done. An admirable effort. And the ending? Absolutely transformative. I am humbled.
No problem.
What the hell just happened? Was that real?
Shake it off. Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
'Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave! Caliban! Come forth,
come
I say!
On!
Come on, Nathan.
As wicked do, as e'er my mother brushed.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself. Filth as thou art, I have lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Oh, God.
Shit.
Shut up, guys.
He's crying.
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
Fuck you.
Where should this music be? In the air or the earth?
Oh, thank God.
This play is super intense.
What is it? A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor!
Do you love me?
O heaven, O earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves. Now my charms are all overthrown, and what strength I have's mine own. Pray, release me from my bands, with the help of your good hands.
Actually seems like a pretty cool play. I want to look it up later.
Wasn't that fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah? How dead?
Hella dead.
Not supposed to be here. I hope the principal isn't watching. Oh shit, she's here.
Oh my god, Keaton's face behind you when you walked on stage? I was shitting myself.
In the dead of night, I'll meet you in my sleep.
He was shitting himself.
That dude owes me.
In the morning light, you wake up next to me. Like a dream come true.
That bike is following me.
You that the entire fate of our production rests upon your slender shoulders. I've never had an experience like that on stage. Yeah, right? You were...
No, you.
Like, seriously, I love nights after a show.
Is it always like this?
Oh, totally. It's such a high. No more nerves, just the adrenaline. So, first-timer, are you proud of yourself?
I'm more relieved.
I think I'm just happy it's over. The last 12 hours have been freaking intense.
It's been one hell of a day.
You've gone through so much shit today.
Right now is pretty good. Okay. The whole show was good. I admit it.
Yeah. It was magical.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's just hold hands. It'd be rude for me to decline it after all. So what was that whole I want my money thing that happened?
Let's leave. For real.
Like
for
at
real.
The end of the last episode.
You said you wanted to skip town and never look back. Like I said last night. Let's do it.
We need some money though.
I know. I've been thinking about that all day.
But that was...
Don't say it was just a crazy thought. You mean it. I can tell.
You want this.
Yeah, but, like, eventually.
Let's go now. Didn't we already agree on stage?
We can't just...
Why not?
Money?
What about money?
I thought you were a high-rolling criminal now.
I gave the money away.
I collected the money Frank wanted, but then I gave it back to Drew instead.
It sounded like he needs it more.
No shit. But man, I'm not looking forward to what Frank has to say when he finds out.
We'll figure it out, Chloe. Anyway, I've got more than enough to start us out. I always get birthday money from my dad.
Or should I say, hush money.
Any more questions?
I don't really care about parents that much, but middle of nowhere?
How far could we possibly get without a car?
I thought you were fixing that truck in the junkyard.
I was just seeing if I could.
Well, can you or can't you?
Maybe. Well, we all know that definitely.
Yeah, I can.
That's hot.
Ooh.
In other words, we've got transportation covered.
All right, fine, you win.
Fine then, drama queen. Where are we going?
You tell me. What uniquely twisted location does Chloe Price plus Rachel Amber equal?
The open road.
I'm feeling like an indefinitely long road trip.
That sounds like the greatest idea anyone's ever thought of. You and me, driving down the coast, filling up our truck with hilarious souvenirs, and every night, we'll find a different beach to walk along and watch the sun go down. And one day, you'll be at a gas station fixing the brakes, and some guy with no shirt on will come up.
Yeah. Okay.
He'll be like, that's so hot that you know about cars. And I'll say, back off. She's with me.
You're full of shit.
I love this time of night. Don't you just feel like everything's possible?
Rachel, stop. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life. Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
A kiss. A tattoo? The tattoo's pretty serious. But a kiss for now is fine.
How about,
Oh.
Hope no creepy guy is watching in the bushes. Oh wait, I am.
Is that convincing enough?
Yeah.
Oh, even more convincing.
Holy shit.
Yeah, that was hot.
Right?
Is that ash or snow?
What is this stuff?
It's ash.
I think it's a sign. I think we should leave tonight.
Really?
Car.
If you want to. I'm ready.
Let's go sneak some clothes and stuff from my house. And then we'll get the hell out of Arcadia Bay. That sounds perfect.
Oh, shit's about to hit the fan. Wow, that's a really nice house. You got stained glass windows as your front door? Are you serious? Got the smooth jazz playing. You didn't go watch the play?
Rose! Rachel's home! And she, brought her new friend.
Hey.
Our star returns! You're just in time. Dinner's almost ready. Chloe, was it?
It was.
It was, but that was before I was expelled. Now, it's that girl who used to go here. What was her name again? All one word.
It's a long name.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to bring up any sore subjects.
Who's sore?
Rachel, honey, you were resplendent tonight.
Oh, you did go.
Thanks.
See it.
Chloe, you must join us for dinner tonight.
She must? I must?
Of course.
I made chicken a la king. I'm sure you both acted up quite the appetite.
I'm not really hungry.
Yeah, no thanks. I'm more of a burger a la king kind of gal.
She's funny, this one.
I'm aware.
Chloe, I know we didn't exactly meet each other at our best this morning, but with you and Rachel becoming such fast friends, I insist you join us for dinner. Don't you agree, Rachel?
Yes, of course. Chloe, would you join us for dinner, please?
Of course.
Great. I just need to wash off. Then I'll be right down.
Don't be long. In meantime, perhaps you can help me with the table, Chloe?
Sure thing, Mrs. Amber.
You know, if it wasn't for
okay,
the dad being a cheater...
I'm gonna go pack. After dinner, we can make our break. You cool down here?
They seem like a pretty cool family. Hurry back, though.
Just hurry back. I don't know how long I can keep this up.
Try doing it your whole life.
Ooh.
And, Chloe, we just need to make it through dinner. Try not to say anything that, you know...
That I would normally say.
Exactly.
That's gonna be tough.
Just some quality time with the Ambers. What could possibly go wrong?
There we go. I heard you were in the Tempest. Yeah, it was kind of a big deal. I believe it. Everyone says the show was awesome. You get medals for two good deeds today. Drew's okay. Mikey will text you an update in a bit. Oh shit, tell them both I'm pulling for him. Alright, well, at least they're both okay. So...
It's like a thousand times more skeevy when the skeeviness is all polite to your face.
Oh yeah, it is. Should I really use that in front of him?
Easy to see who wears the literary pants around here.
Well, let's see if I can use the computer.
Doing the play was bad enough without having to read about it afterwards. Hope Drew's okay, though. How to clear browser history, followed by a gap for all of yesterday. That's like cheating asshat 101.
How do you clear, like, poor one Rachel. Day, but, like, miss out the rest of the days? It's like you want to get caught. Whatever. Oh, I got some ammunition to talk about now.
Hiya, Mr. Amber.
Chloe, what can I do for you?
Well...
Your daughter's pretty great.
Thank you. We're fond of her as well.
You ever feel like she's so awesome at everything that you just want to shake her? Yeah. Me neither.
I don't even know where you were going with that, Chloe.
What do you think? I thought Rachel was perfectly cast.
She certainly was. We're very proud of her. I had no idea they were going to do that.
Do what?
I don't know the name for it. Reverse casting? Casting a woman as a man?
Oh, I just meant the wizard part.
I suppose that's also true.
So, you're a district attorney, huh?
I'm your district attorney.
So I can call you if I'm ever district arrested?
What would you be arrested for?
Oh, no.
It was a joke. Not a good one, clearly.
Yeah, this guy's a little too serious. I gotta go.
Duty calls. Hey, good chat, Mr. Amber.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. Well, he's lost points with me.
Huh. Rachel really was an overachiever before she met me. Glad I nipped that in the bud.
Yep, can't have people rising too high too quickly. Waller?
Oh, I think that's an original Who Gives a Shit.
Is that like a crown? Somebody at Burger King draw this? Crossword puzzle. Ooh, let's improve it. Literal.
Solved it.
Good luck solving that one, guys.
Something about this photo doesn't seem right. I should fix it. Can't tag this while Rachel's mom is right there. She totally bust me.
Well, they would still totally know who it was. What do you got hiding in here?
No skeletons. Lots of shiny dishes, though.
Where's Mikey? That says you're there. Hey, Chloe. She's out of surgery. In pain, but okay. Holy shit, Mikey. I'm so sorry. It's okay. You stuck with me. Plus, you saved our money. We owe you. I should have helped more. Hey, Steph says you were in the play. What? I've had a busy day. More heroes. Most heroes do. Alright, well, let's see what we can do.
Hey there, Mrs. Amber.
Chloe, I'm so glad you're joining us tonight.
So, the play.
What did you think of the play?
Rachel was typically amazing, but I never liked The Tempest. What did you think of it?
To be honest, I only really read a couple pages. Theater's not really my thing. I guess I'm not so into saying words someone else came up with.
Fair point. Then again, I'm not sure you can judge the entire art form based on the dead white men your curriculum focuses on.
Damn. Shots fired, Shakespeare. So, Rachel was pretty awesome tonight.
Yes, she was. Though, to be fair, she's pretty awesome every night. I wish I were half as driven when I was her age.
Me too.
I get the sense that you're a force of nature yourself. I can see why the two of you get along so well.
You can? Because it still seems crazy to me. Integrity,
honesty, loyalty.
What?
It's on your lawn.
Oh, right. Sorry. I guess I'm still getting used to being an elected official's wife.
Some strong words. What about your married life?
What's it like being married to the DA?
Much like being married to anyone else, I imagine.
But with a lot more secrets, right?
Secrets?
Like attorney-client privilege and all that.
Well, as district attorney, he brings cases against criminals on behalf of the state. He doesn't defend them.
Of course not.
So, about selling the
paper. So, you putting me to work, or what?
Yes. If you could please take 4 plates from the cupboard and set them on the table.
What if I can't?
Excuse me?
You said if I could. Never mind.
Man.
You're a riot, Chloe.
Well, at least
all right, Chloe, you've set the table without ruining someone's marriage before. Piece of cake. It's off to the table with you.
Yes, Chloe?
What's next?
Plates? Check. Anything else?
Actually, could you be a dear and ask Mr. Amber what he'd like to drink with dinner?
I will be a dear. Talking to James. As long as I can avoid using the words cheating and scumbag, I should be fine.
Why did she call him Mr. Amber and not like his first name or my husband?
Something else?
What's your vice, Mr. Amber?
I'm sorry?
Your wife wants to know what kind of drink you're having.
Ah, let's say sherry.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, sherry.
Comical. Chloe, maybe you can help me understand something.
I'll give it a shot.
Rose and I, we're worried about Rachel. Yesterday was so unlike her. What do you suppose is going on?
Besides you?
Hard to say. Maybe she's rebelling against something. Or someone.
What would Rachel have to rebel against? We've given her everything she could ask for. Yet, I'm not sure I buy the narrative you laid out this morning in the principal's office. Rachel is not known for following along with anything she doesn't want to. I'd be lying if I said I didn't have concerns about your friendship, but perhaps you're exactly who Rachel needs right now as she navigates the choppy waters of adolescence.
You'd be surprised.
Thanks.
Well, he wants some sherry. He didn't say it with me, though.
Yes, Chloe?
The boss man would like a sherry.
Thank you. The glasses are in the china cabinet. You can place one at his setting.
How am I supposed to get to China? Kidding.
Come on, people.
It's the fancy-looking cabinet, right?
You got it.
God, you guys are so dry. Well, this isn't awkward at all.
So, Chloe, are you and Rachel in any of the same classes?
Not anymore.
Not since this morning.
Oh, gosh, I'm so sorry.
Strike 2. That's cool. We're not.
What about that fire?
Dinner's really good, Mom.
Thank you, Rachel. The way the fire spreads so fast, I've never heard of anything like it.
It's pretty strange.
It's almost surreal. They say a fire like that could only come from a crime of passion.
Passion? What does that mean?
I don't know. You tell me. 'Cause you're the DA, of course.
Not like I know the other passionate things that you're doing.
The latest report from the commissioner's office suggests arson.
Arson? Why would anyone do that?
Any number of reasons. With everything going on in the world today, even a town like Arcadia Bay isn't immune to the ills of society.
I cannot imagine how difficult these last few years have been for you, Chloe. Now that you and Rachel have become friends, I want you to know that our home is always open to you.
Cool. Thanks.
Oh, God.
Well
Rachel
said,
doesn't
dear.
Look good.
It's imperative in such troubled times as these that we remember what is most important to us.
She's gonna snap.
Family's not merely a gift. It is a responsibility. As such, those we love must be cared for and never, ever taken for granted.
Okay, for once, I'm gonna try not being the asshole like she told me to. Now let's just calm her down.
Yeah, that's super true. And also remember, Rachel, that even when shit's like the lamest ever, you can always run away from whatever's bothering you. As long as you just keep calm.
An interesting philosophy, Chloe.
Yes, indeed. Not one that I would endorse, however. I favor confronting my problems head on. But to each their own, I suppose.
Oh, fucking blow me.
Rachel!
Oh, shit. Let's distract.
Crap. I'm so clumsy. Rachel, can you come help me find another
Stop
fork?
It, Chloe.
He told me to behave.
I can't sit here and listen to this bullshit anymore.
Rachel!
Stop it, Dad! You're a hypocrite! Okay? I know! You lying, cheating, piece of shit, motherfucker!
Excuse me?
We saw you yesterday at the Overlook.
James?
Kissing that woman.
James.
Rachel? Honey, whatever you saw or think you saw, I know it's hard, but I need you to trust me.
Trust you?
No offense, Mr. Amber, but I think we trust our eyes more than you.
That's enough! You are not welcome here or around my daughter any longer. I know exactly what kind of person you are from the moment I saw you, and I let my wife's compassion get the better of you.
Oh? What kind of person is
a
that?
A delinquent. A broken girl from a broken home.
That's enough, James. I will not have you continue to speak to me like this.
Oh, crap. Oh, shit. Does she actually have a power? Okay,
why can't you just tell me the fucking truth? Stop lying! Stop being a politician for one fucking minute! Can't you just be my dad?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress.
That's a nicer way of saying it.
That was your mother.
What?
Shadows settle on the place that you left. Our minds are troubled by the emptiness. Destroy the middle, it's a waste of time. From the perfect start to the finish line.
And if you're still breathing, you're the lucky ones. 'Cause most of us are heaving through corrupted lungs, setting fire to our insides for fun, collecting names of the lovers that went wrong, the lovers that went wrong. Because most of us are bitter over someone, setting fire to our insides for fun, to distract our hearts from ever missing love. But I'm forever missing you.
You wanted to.